I have a little game here with foes and friends, and I will show you how it works. Let's just focus on this side of the screen, where I'm going to run the game. I'll run this game, continue to run. Okay, enter number for 1 to 10. And depending on what I enter randomly, one character of the game will be hit or the other character. So I'll enter a 1, I'll enter a 4, a 5, an 8, a 2, a 5, a 6. And then when I enter a 0, the game stops and it reports the status of each of the players. So it says the bad guy's health is 54 and the good guy's health is 87. So the good guy's winning. Now let me show you how this works really quickly. I'm importing scanner and random. So if I'm importing scanner, I'm going to read something. And random, I'm going to use a random number somewhere. I have this class game. In the main method, I create a scanner for the keyboard. I initialize a value to 1, and I initialize a random number generator. I have a variable called goodguy, which is of type friend. It's going to be a new friend, and I'll set the health to 100. I have a badguy, variable called badguy, which is a class of type foe, and I'm going to set the health of this guy to 90. Now, while the value is greater than 0, remember starts at 1 at the beginning, I'm going to do enter number from 1 to 10, and the value is going to be that whatever number you enter. I'm going to create a random number, a number from 0 to 9, right? This is what this 10 means. It's from 0 to this number exclusively, right? And then I'm going to say, well, the value that you enter is greater than this random number, then the good guy takes a hit. Otherwise, the bad guy takes a hit. Now, if you enter 0, well, it's going to be 0. It's no longer going to be greater than 0, and therefore it's going to exit, and then it's going to print bad guy's health, bad guy dot get health, and good guy dot get health. So it's going to print the health of both characters. Okay. Take a minute to look at this program and understand what it's doing. Okay. Understand what it's doing. Now, what I want to really focus on here is these classes, friend and foe, okay? You see that I'm using a lot of methods here for friend and foe. Set health, take hit on both, get health in both. And the hope here is that if I were to code another kind of character, so the treacherous character or some, you know, weasel character or something that's not a friend or a foe, but it's a different kind of character with its different properties, you know, I would kind of want to use these same methods because, for example, the one I trust that a good guy or a bad guy are going to have a take hit method, okay? I trust that they're gonna have this. And I don't want to go to your code to see how does your character takes a hit? I mean, I would really like to call a method called take hit for all of them, so I know that whenever you have a character, it can just take a hit. Okay. I know that you can have a get health and a set health method. I would really like to trust that you call those methods the same way. So then, when I program my character, I don't have to do a lot of work to guess what methods I should implement in my new character so that your game can actually call that character, okay? Basically, I want to make these classes, friend and foe, because they're both characters of a game, I want to make them as standard as possible. If you've watched the videos on inheritance, you know already that friend and foe could inherit from a common class, say, player or character. Right? And then they might have all the same methods. But here's the caveat. Let's look at the foe class. The foe class, when I set the health, I set it to X. And then when I get the health, I get the health. It's fine. And when I take a hit, I reduce the health by 10%. I reduce the health by 1/10 of the health. Right? However, for the friend, okay, to set the health is the same, get the health is the same. Now take hit, okay, for take hit, I reduce the health by less, right? So I reduced the health by now 5%, but not 10%, okay? So this divided by 20 means that, right? So if the health is 100, I'm going to reduce the health here by 5 and not by 10, like in the other case. So the take hit does different things depending on whether you're a friend or a foe, right? Now, my game couldn't care less. It just says, you know, these are the conditions for one taking the hit or the other. They do whatever they want, right? So the good guy takes the hit, the bad guy takes the hit. Now, if I were inheriting from a common class called character, so let's create this class, right? Java public class character. I could have this game, I could have this method, right? So public void take hit. And let's say, we'll probably want to have a variable called health. And the take hit, what it'll do, it'll say health minus equals health divided by 10, for example, right? So it diminishes the health in 10%. And then friend and foe can inherit from this class. So foe can extends character, and friend extends character. Okay, so let me save everything. Save character, and then compile the game. Now, notice that even if I am inheriting from character, I would still have to overwrite, say, I want this to be 5 now, right? What happens is I still have to overwrite this method. So really inheriting from the character class doesn't give me much, right? It's not helping me a lot, right? Because I'll still have to implement it. Now the problem with this comes in here. Say in friend, I do not implement this method. I forgot. I'm creating a character for a game and I forgot to implement this method, right? My game's still gonna run, right? Because friend inherits from character and character already has this method coded in it, right? And that is a problem. Why? Well, because I forgot to implement this method, so my friend is defective, is reducing its health at the same ratio as perhaps is not what I wanted to do, but I forgot, right? Or the other thing that I can do in the friend is instead of calling this method take hit, I would call this method public void ouch, right? And then my ouch method has health equals minus equals health divided by 5, for example, right? Now, because I call this method ouch, right, the game class is never going to call that method, doesn't know that that method exists. And it doesn't know that, for example, I mean, it would be more work for the developer to go and figure out that good guys, instead of taking hit, now say ouch, right? And the compiler will never alert me from this. Now, if I want to standardize a class, well, what I really want to do is this. I want foe and friend to assure me that they're going to implement set health, take hit, and get health. I want them to assure me that they're going to have their own implementation of these methods, that the coder will actually have to go and code these exact methods, okay? In other words, I want to ensure that friend and foe abide by a contract that says you must implement the set health method with an int, you must implement a take hit method with nothing in it, and you must implement a get health method with nothing in it. I want them to abide by this contract, okay? And if a developer does not abide by this contract, I want the class not to be able to compile. I really want the developer to actually do these exact methods, nothing, at least these three, okay? Inheritance so far doesn't give us that. Inheritance so far, I can inherit stuff, but there's nothing that says I must re-implement these methods. This is where interfaces come in.